subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Hello friends, welcome to the channel DevDbQa.com. In this video, we will learn about test case, components of test case, how to write test cases, and test case management tools. So let's start. Test case. The test case is defined as a group of conditions under which a tester determines whether a software application is working as per the customer requirements or not. Test case designing includes preconditions, case name, input conditions, and expected results. A test case is a first level action and derived from the test scenarios. So, test case is a group of conditions under which the tester determines the behavior of the software application is according to the customer requirements or not. In test cases, the preconditions, case name, input conditions, and expected results are the components of test case. The test cases are derived from the test scenarios. Test case gives detailed information about testing strategy, testing process, preconditions, and expected outputs. These are executed during the testing process to check whether the software application is performing the task for that it was developed or not. So the test cases are executed in the testing process to check the software application is performing as expected or not. Writing of test cases is one-time attempt that can be used in future at the time of regression testing also. So the test cases that are written for the testing of the software can be used for regression testing also. Test case helps the tester in defect reporting by linking defect with the test case ID. So a test case ID is assigned to every test case so that the defect reporting can be done by the tester, and linking to the defect of the test cases is done with the help of test case ID. Detailed test case document works as a foolproof guard for testing team because if developer missed something, then it can be caught during the execution of these foolproof test cases. Components of a test case. Usually, there is no formal template for test case writing, but the following components are always included in every test case. Number 1, test case ID. Number 2, preconditions. Number 3, purpose, steps, actual outcome, expected outcome, assumptions, product module, product version, and revision history. Post conditions. So here is the example of a test case template. Here you can see that first of all, the project name, module name, reference document created by, date of creation and date of review fields are present. So the details are to be written by the tester as what is the project name. For example, here we have taken the example of Google email login page, and second is module name, module is login, reference document, if there is any reference document present, then the details of the document is written in this section. Created by the user, the tester, the name of tester is written in this field. Date of creation, the date of creation of the test case is written in this field. Date of review, the date of review of the test cases are written in this field. So these are the different components of test cases. First is test case ID. Another is test scenario. Third is test case, precondition, test steps, test data, expected result, post condition, actual result, and last the status that the test case is passed or failed. So first of all, we will assign a test case ID to the test case. For example, here the test case ID is TC_login_001. Then the test scenario. We will write the test scenario that is written for the test case, that is verify the login of Gmail. Then the test case. Enter a valid username and valid password is the test case. So for this test case, what should be the precondition? The precondition should be we need a valid Gmail account to do the login. So to do the login, we need a valid Gmail account. That is the precondition of for this test case. And then to test the test case, the test steps are, first of all, we will have to enter the username, then the password, then click on the login button. The test data includes the username that is used for login, the and the password that is used, which is the valid password for login. And the unexpected result, we will write the expected result that is caused by the test steps. So if we follow the test steps, and the then the expected result should be successful login of the Gmail. Then post condition is, if the successful login is done, then the Gmail inbox is shown to the user. So it will be the post condition. So in this type of template, we write all the test case and all the test case ID and all these fields for the test case are written in this type of template. So this is called test case template. Next is best practice for writing good test case. Number one, test case need to be simple and transparent. Create test case with end user in mind. So the test cases are written with keeping the end user in mind, because the software or the application have to be used by the end user only. Avoid test case repetition. Do not assume the, so in this step means, do not assume anything on our own. The tester should not assume anything on his own, but the tester should follow the requirement document to write the test cases. Ensure 100% coverage. So the tester should ensure that the test case should cover the 100% coverage of the application or the software. Test cases must be identifiable. So the test cases should have a test case ID with which the test case can be identified. Implement testing techniques. So the tester should write the test cases by implementing the testing techniques such as boundary value analysis, equivalence partitioning, and error guessing. So all these techniques are used for writing the test cases. Peer review. So if one tester has written the test cases, then he should give the test cases to review to another tester, so that the if there is any gap or if there any requirement that is missed by one tester can be covered by the another tester after the review. Test case management tools. Test case management tools are the automation tools that help to manage and maintain the test cases. Main features of a test case management tool are, number one, for documenting test cases. So with tools, we can expedite the test case creation with the use of templates, execute the test case and record the results. So test case can be executed through the tools and results can be obtained by easily recorded. Automate the defect tracking. Failed tests are automatically linked to the bug tracker, which in turn can be assigned to the developers and can be tracked by email notifications. Traceability. Requirements, test cases, execution of the test cases are all interlinked through the tools, and each case can be traced to each other to check the test coverage. So there are different type of test case management tools which we can use for documenting the test case, for automate the defect tracking, for traceability, for test case execution and recording of the results. And at last, protecting the test cases. Test case should be reusable and should be protected from being lost or corrupted due to poor version control. Test case management tools offer features like the version control, the traceability, automate the defect tracking, execute the test case and record the result. All of these features are provided by the test case management tools. So guys, that's all in this video. In this video, we learned about the test case, how to write test case, the template of test case, and the different type of test case management tools and the features of test case management tools. If you like my video, then please press the like button and please subscribe to my channel to get regular updates. If you have any suggestion, then please comment in the comment section. Thank you.